everyone, Alexa here from the blog theduvallhomestead.com. Today I'm going to show you how to sew really easy rod pocket curtains. I have a glorious hour or so right now because it is nap time for my almost 7 month old baby, and I have been wanting to make these curtains for these two windows that we have in our living room, and I just thought, let's just do it really quick. Luckily, this is fast enough to do in an hour. I've sewn a few different types of curtains, all of which take me way longer. So I am not an advanced sewer by any means. I'm definitely a beginner. I've only been sewing for a couple of years. And I really like sewing projects that are square, simple, and that I can put together quickly because I just don't have an official sewing room or a whole lot of time to sew. So this is a project that falls under that category, and that is why I like it. I've done curtains in the past with tie top and other fancy ruffles and whatnot, and although they're pretty, I really just needed to get curtains up in our living room, and I just didn't have a whole lot of time now that I have a baby. And so this is something that you can really do very fast, and it's very easy. And I don't have any official sewing training, and so if I miss something in this video, or if something in this video sounds not like what you learned in a sewing class, you might be right, because I have never had an official sewing class. I just kind of taught myself and have learned via the internet, etc. So you're going to start by measuring your window. In our case, we had a square window that was 22 inches by 22 inches. I also got these really easy expandable curtain rods off Amazon. I've used them before and they were perfect for that space. They just twist and they can fit any certain space within a certain dimension. So the first thing you want to do is put your curtain rod up in your window and see where it's going to fit and see how long you want your curtain to go. This tutorial is for a very small window, so this might be a little different than if you were to make big drapes or something that's gonna cover a big window, and if you want them to be bunched on the floor, that's not really what I'm going for here. So what you do wanna do is multiply the width of your curtain by 1.5. And that's just because you don't want your curtain to only fit just the square of the window, you want it to be a little bit bundled. Then you wanna add about 4 inches to the width to account for a hem, and about 12 inches to the height to account for the pocket for the rod and for another hem on the bottom. So in total, my fabric was 37 inches wide and 34 inches tall. So I started off with a window that was 22 by 22 and I ended up with fabric that was 37 inches wide, 34 inches tall. So first you wanna just sew a nice hem on both sides. Fold the two sides over 1/2 inch and then another 1/2 inch. And use an iron to flatten it down. Now, I told you to add 4 inches for the hem on either side, and if you do 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch, then you're going to end up with only 2 inches of hem on either side. But I accounted for 4 because, quite honestly, I don't always cut straight lines, and I don't measure the hem either. I know there's some hem measures you can get, and I just don't have that. So I said 4 inches because I don't really care about this right now because the curtain is going to look beautiful no matter what. It doesn't matter if it's an inch or so. I'd rather have it too big though than too small. I have sewn curtains in the past that are too small and they barely fit the window when I was first learning how to sew a curtain, and you definitely don't want that. So in my opinion, you can't go wide enough, so that's why I added on 4 inches for the width hem, but I'm only doing basically a 1 inch hem on each side. So just like any hem that you're going to sew, you fold it over twice, 1/2 inch and then 1/2 inch. So first you fold it, then you iron it, then you pin it, and then you sew it. So we're gonna use that process for both sides of the curtain. Sew along both the two sides, making sure to backward and forward stitch at the beginning and the end. Next, we're going to sew the pocket for the rod. You want to look at the size of your curtain rod. Mine is about 1 inch at its widest point. You want to double it. And so I made sure that my pocket was about 2 inches. So fold the top over 2 inches, and then you fold it another 2 inches and pin it in place. Make sure that the back of the curtain is facing up here, so that all of your back is on the top. It does help to have a fabric with horizontal lines like this one, because then I don't have to use a ruler or any tool to see that I'm sewing straight. And when I fold, I can fold over onto a line and know that I am in fact going straight because I'm following the lines. It's helpful to have your curtain rod nearby so that you can make sure that it's going to fit and you can get a feel for how it's gonna look. So just like with the sides, you want to first fold, second iron, third pin, fourth sew, making sure you go backward and forward at the beginning and the end. Okay, now that you've done the two sides and the top pocket, you should go back to your window and put it up. So I went ahead and just hung this up to see where it landed. Now we have a little planter in the front of our window and I noticed that the curtain went far over the planter and I thought, well, I can either cut the fabric and make it so that it is just landing right on top of the planter, or I can keep it long and then drape the fabric kind of to the side. Now, I played around with it on the window for a little bit and found out that I do need to keep it quite long if I want to kind of pin it up on the side and have it still drape over next to the plants. And so I'm glad I did that 12 inch at the top. That's why I'm recommending you have a lot of extra space, especially if you're going to have curtains that hit the ground and you want them to bundle on the ground, right? Because you don't want them to hang just right on top of the ground. You want them to kind of bundle. So with that said, I decided to just do a half inch fold, another half inch fold. So a total of 1 inch on the bottom. Same process here. You fold, iron, pin, and then sew. Now, another thing you want to think about when you're doing the bottom of the curtain is whether or not you want some weight, because especially if you're doing long curtains that fall to the ground, you want them to be kind of heavy on the bottom so they can bunch up. In my case, I didn't think that that was super important here, but if you wanted more weight, you could do like a 3-inch hem and really add more weight to the bottom. Now you're done with your curtain. The last thing that I'm going to do though, just to give it that nice touch that's just kind of pretty and makes it maybe stand out a little more, is I'm going to top stitch along the very bottom and the very top. I've got my rod pocket here, as you can see, and I'm going to just top stitch, which means I'm just gonna go along this outer edge here and just go right on top of the fabric all the way down, just to flatten it out, and it just makes it look pretty when I go to hang it. Okay, well that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to sew a rod pocket curtain. I'll have a link to a blog post down below where I talk more about how to do this and printable instructions if you are more of a visual person and you want to print this out so you can look at it while you do your project. If you're brand new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. Every week I post new farm to table recipes and homemade natural living. If you do this tutorial or you have a sewing project that you think I would love if you'd share it with me or write it down in the comments below. Thank you so much for stopping by the Duvall Homestead.